Art practice is predominantly drawing and painting, and I do some performance. The drawings and paintings are monochromatic, black and white. They're figurative, narrative, and full of humor, and very easily accessible. And the performances are, I guess they're really kind of repulsive, but full of humor and very entertaining. So I dress as a clown, which is quite miserable. And I also wear an unusual costume that has lots of fingers. That's pretty awful as well. When I was at art school, I practiced karate, and I thought it'd be quite nice to come to Japan and practice karate in Japan and have an adventure. I didn't know how long I was going to stay, or if I was going to stay or leave the next day. And it just turned out that I ended up staying 26 years, probably forever. I instantly felt comfortable here, and I didn't feel out of place, even though I probably was quite different, obviously. But I didn't feel uncomfortable about that at all. I felt more comfortable in Japan than I did in Glasgow, where I was born and raised. I like watching people, and I like observing everything about them. And my inspiration comes just from observation and listening to the stupid things that they do. I find that very interesting. I guess being exposed to the news, you hear of all the foolish activities that people involve themselves in. And that inspires my work, because my work's full of humour, and some of these activities are very very comedy-like. I'm also inspired by movies and books and music. I like black and white films, and all my drawings and paintings are in black and white. I could name lots of films, but Kind Hearts and Coronets is probably a good film as a source of inspiration. I don't think there's been a great deal of influence from Japanese culture consciously, but probably unconsciously. I'm influenced by it, and I don't really know. But certainly the discipline of karate and the harmony and balance of Japanese culture and society probably has had some influence, unconscious influence on my work. I don't feel like I have a career as an artist, because it's just part of my life, but I think some of the most important points were first coming to Japan, and that was a really big, important life move rather than career move. And I suppose as an artist, a few years ago, I exhibited a painting based on Peer Gynt, the Ibsen play, and my friend and I were invited to Cairo as guests of the Queen of Norway to show the painting, and that was very memorable as a career highlight. I think just being able to sustain painting every day is my ultimate goal. Painting every day, practicing karate every day, and taking my dog for a walk. Ironically, as an artist, I don't really like art much at all. Well, my art is for me, is everything. But other people's art is really very little, I suppose. Unless, of course, it is something I do like. My art is very interesting for me. I don't really need anything else.